Hi, this is Anil from Learning Lad and welcome to the Guess the Output video series on C programming language. In this video, I have a C program in the screen. All you have to do is pause this video and take a look at the source code, and then first you need to find whether this program contains any errors. If you think this program is error-free, then you need to guess the output of the program. Once you have an answer for this program, you can play the video. I'm going to run the program and explain whatever the output will come. Now you guys can pause this video. Alright, now I think you guys have an answer for this program. I'm gonna build and run this. So I'm going to do build and run. And the output that we get for this program is welcome to Learning Lad. So now why we get the output like this? Here if you look at the source code, first we have defined a macro called YouTube, and the definition of this macro YouTube is main. And then we have a printf statement inside this function, which will display welcome to Learning Lad. So here all of you know that in a C program, we should have one main function. Now, if you look at the source code here, then we don't have a main function, but still our program runs. So why this program runs? Now, before the actual compilation process, there is a step called as the pre-processing, and during the pre-processing, the preprocessor program will search for the macros used in the program, and it will replace those macros with that macro's definition. So here the preprocessor will search for YouTube in this code, and then it will replace that with main. So the output of the preprocessor will contain this main function, because it will replace this YouTube with main. And then that output of the preprocessor is passed on to the compiler for the compilation process. And during that time, this code has a main function and we haven't made any mistake in the code. And that's why, we get the output welcome to Learning Lad. Now, if you want to check the output of the preprocessor, then you can do that. For that, first you have to open the folder where you have saved this program. To demonstrate that, I'm going to open up the folder where I have stored this program. And here, as you guys can see, I have stored this program inside the what is the output folder, which is inside C programming folder, which is inside the source codes folder, which is in the D drive. So to check the output of the preprocessor, I need to open up the command prompt in this location. So I can open up the command prompt by going to the URL bar and just by typing the CMD here. And if I hit the enter button, you guys can see we have the command prompt, which is inside this folder. So now here, what I can do is I can write a command. The command is GCC, and then we use -e to only pre-process the code. It will not compile the code. It will just do the pre-processing. And then we need to leave a space, and then we need to write the file name where we have the source code. The source code is inside this main.c file. So I'm gonna specify that here, main.c. And if I hit the enter button, it will, display a lot of things. These are the things the preprocessor has done. First, it has included the stdio.h header file's content to our file. And then in the end, you guys can see our main function. Here, we don't have a YouTube, we have main function. Or, YouTube has been replaced with the main. So this is the work of the preprocessor. And when this code is compiled, we have a main function and all other things are proper. And that's why this program runs and we get the output as welcome to Learning Lad. So this is it guys for this video. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, then hit that dislike button. And if you want to say something, then write that in the comment box. And if you think this video will help any of your friends, then do share this video with them. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later in the next video.